Our solar system is home to a diverse array of planets, each with its own unique set of characteristics and features. Earth is a remarkable planet in our solar system that supports life in all its diverse forms. From the towering trees of the Amazon rainforest to the tiny microbes living deep beneath the ocean floor, Earth's biosphere is a testament to the remarkable adaptability and resilience of life. Most of the other planets have environments that are unsuitable for life as we know it. They offer an intriguing glimpse into the vast and varied nature of our universe. One of the most fascinating aspects of these planets is their land, which can look vastly different from the landscapes we are familiar with on Earth. From rocky, cratered surfaces to vast gas giants with no solid ground at all. Each planet in our solar system has its own story to tell about the nature and history of our solar system. In this video, we will take a closer look at the appearance of the surface on all of the planets in our solar system. Mercury. Mercury is a small and rocky planet, with a diameter of just 4,880 kilometers or 3,032 miles, making it slightly larger than Earth's moon. It is the closest planet to the Sun, and as a result, it has a very harsh environment, with surface temperatures that can range from minus 173 degrees Celsius at night to 427 degrees Celsius during the day. The surface of Mercury is heavily cratered, indicating that the planet has been bombarded by meteoroids and asteroids over the course of its history. These impact craters can vary in size from small, shallow depressions to large, deep basins. One of the most prominent features on Mercury's surface is the Caloris Basin, which is a large impact crater that measures around 1,550 kilometers or 960 miles in diameter. The impact that created the Caloris Basin was so massive that it caused shockwaves that traveled across the planet and caused other geological features, such as the strange, spider-like fractures that are visible on the surface. In addition to impact craters, Mercury's surface is also covered in dust and rocky debris. There are also several steep cliffs and crater rims that can reach up to a mile high, such as the cliff known as Enterprise Rupees. These cliffs are thought to have been formed as the planet's crust contracted and buckled due to cooling. Overall, Mercury's surface is a rugged and inhospitable environment, with extreme temperature fluctuations and a high degree of geological activity. However, it is also a fascinating planet to study, as it provides insight into the early history of our solar system and the processes that shape planetary surfaces. Venus. Venus is often referred to as Earth's sister planet due to its similar size, mass, and composition. However, its surface is very different from Earth's, with a thick, toxic atmosphere and extreme temperatures that make it one of the most inhospitable places in the solar system. Venus' thick atmosphere is mainly composed of sulfuric acid clouds, which create a strong greenhouse effect and contribute to the planet's scorching temperatures. The average surface temperature on Venus is around 460 degrees Celsius, which is hot enough to melt lead. The surface of Venus is not visible in visible light due to the thick layer of clouds that surrounds the planet. However, radar imaging has provided us with a detailed view of its surface. The surface of Venus is rocky and volcanic, with vast plains and towering mountains. The planet's surface is dominated by a series of plateaus and highlands, which are broken up by deep rift valleys and canyons. The highest point on Venus, called Maxwell Montes, is located near the planet's equator and rises to a height of 11 kilometers or 7 miles above the average surface level. The planet also has a large impact crater called Meade, which is located on the planet's southern hemisphere. This crater is approximately 280 kilometers or 174 miles in diameter and is believed to have been formed by a meteorite impact. Other notable surface features on Venus include lava flows and volcanic domes, which are thought to have been formed by volcanic activity in the planet's past. One of the most unique features of Venus' surface is the presence of coronae, which are circular or elliptical features that resemble a bullseye target. These coronae are thought to have formed due to the upwelling of magma from beneath the planet's surface, which caused the overlying rock to fracture and form circular depressions. Overall, Venus' surface is a rugged and geologically active environment, with a history of volcanic activity and impact cratering. Despite the harsh conditions, it is a fascinating planet to study, as it provides us with insights into the processes that shape planetary surfaces and the conditions that can exist in other parts of our solar system. Earth. Earth is the third planet from the Sun and the only known planet in the universe that supports life. It has a diverse range of landforms that include mountains, valleys, deserts, forests, and oceans, all of which contribute to the planet's unique ecosystem. The surface of Earth is covered in a thin layer of solid rock, which is broken up into several large plates that float on top of the planet's molten mantle. The movement of these tectonic plates is responsible for many of the planet's most striking landforms. Where plates come together, they can create mountain ranges, such as the Himalayas or the Andes. Where plates move apart, they can create deep valleys, such as the Great Rift Valley in Africa. The interaction between plates can also create volcanoes, earthquakes, and tsunamis, all of which can have a significant impact on the planet's surface and its inhabitants. Earth's surface is also home to a variety of different biomes, each with its own unique set of characteristics and life forms. These biomes include deserts, grasslands, forests, tundra, and aquatic ecosystems, such as oceans and rivers. The planet's oceans cover more than 70% of its surface, and are home to an enormous variety of marine life, from tiny plankton to giant whales. In addition to its natural features, Earth's surface is also shaped by human activity. Cities, roads, and other infrastructure have altered the planet's landscape, and human activities such as deforestation, mining, and agriculture have had a significant impact on the planet's environment. Overall, Earth's surface is a dynamic and ever-changing environment, shaped by natural forces such as tectonic activity and erosion, as well as by human activity. Its diverse range of landforms and ecosystems make it a unique and fascinating planet to study, and a critical component of our understanding of the universe and our place within it. Mars. Mars is the fourth planet from the Sun and is often referred to as the Red Planet due to its reddish appearance. The surface of Mars is rocky and dusty, with vast deserts and canyons stretching across the planet's landscape. The planet is home to towering volcanoes, including Olympus Mons, the largest volcano in the solar system, as well as deep canyons such as Valles Marineris, which is the largest canyon in the solar system. The planet's surface also contains ancient riverbeds, evidence that liquid water once flowed on the planet's surface. The presence of water on Mars is also supported by the polar ice caps, which are made up of frozen carbon dioxide and water. These ice caps expand and contract with the seasons, causing changes in the planet's surface features. Mars' surface is covered in iron oxide, giving it a reddish hue. The iron oxide is a result of the planet's rusty surface, which is due to the presence of iron minerals that have been oxidized by the planet's atmosphere over time. The planet's thin atmosphere and lack of a protective magnetic field have also had a significant impact on its surface features. The atmosphere is primarily composed of carbon dioxide, with small amounts of nitrogen and argon, and is much less dense than Earth's atmosphere. This means that the planet's surface is exposed to high levels of radiation and solar winds, which can erode the planet's surface features and create unusual shapes, such as the strange rock formations found in the Martian landscape. Overall, Mars' surface is a fascinating and unique environment, with a diverse range of geological features that provide valuable insights into the planet's past and present. The presence of water and other resources on the planet also make it a potential target for future exploration and even human colonization. However, any potential colonization efforts would need to take into account factors such as the planetary environment, potential risks to human health, and ethical considerations regarding the impact of human activity on the planet. Additionally, further scientific study and exploration will be needed to better understand the full extent of Mars' resources and the challenges that would need to be overcome to establish a human presence on the planet. Jupiter. Jupiter is the largest planet in our solar system. Jupiter is a gas giant planet, which means that it does not have a solid surface like terrestrial planets such as Earth or Mars. The planet's atmosphere is composed mainly of hydrogen and helium, with traces of other elements such as methane and ammonia. Although Jupiter does not have a solid surface, it does have a complex weather system that is visible through the planet's atmosphere. The planet's most prominent feature is the Great Red Spot, a gigantic storm that has been raging for at least 350 years and is larger than the size of Earth. Jupiter also has numerous other storms and cloud bands that create a distinctive banded appearance in the planet's atmosphere. Jupiter's atmosphere is also characterized by numerous smaller storms, some of which are visible as white or brown spots on the planet's surface. These storms can change in size and shape over time, and some of them can merge with each other to create larger storms. While we cannot see the surface of Jupiter directly, scientists believe that the planet has a solid core made up of rock and metal that is surrounded by a layer of liquid metallic hydrogen, and then a layer of molecular hydrogen. The exact nature of Jupiter's interior is still not well understood, and ongoing studies and observations continue to provide new insights into this giant planet. Saturn. Saturn is the sixth planet from the Sun and is known for its beautiful and unique ring system. Like Jupiter, Saturn is a gas giant planet with no solid surface, which means it does not have a solid surface like Earth or Mars. Instead, its atmosphere gradually transitions into a liquid layer of hydrogen and helium, with increasing pressure and density towards the planet's core. Saturn's most distinctive feature is its system of rings, which consist of countless individual pieces of ice and rock that range in size from tiny grains to large boulders. The rings extend outwards from the planet's equator for tens of thousands of kilometers and are only a few kilometers thick. The rings are also incredibly bright and reflective, giving Saturn a unique and beautiful appearance. Saturn's atmosphere is also very dynamic, with numerous cloud bands and storm systems visible at different latitudes. The planet's most prominent feature is its hexagonal-shaped polar vortex, which is a persisting six-sided atmospheric pattern that sits over the planet's north pole. Overall, while Saturn doesn't have a solid surface to speak of, its rings and atmospheric features make it one of the most visually stunning and interesting planets in our solar system. Uranus. Uranus is an ice giant planet, meaning that it is composed mainly of water, methane, and ammonia ices, rather than being dominated by hydrogen and helium gases like Jupiter and Saturn. Uranus also does not have a solid surface like Earth or Mars. Instead, the outermost layer of Uranus is made up of a thick atmosphere of hydrogen, helium, and methane gases. This atmosphere is characterized by faint cloud bands and small storm systems that circle around the planet's equator. Uranus' most unusual feature is its extreme axial tilt, which causes it to essentially roll on its side as it orbits the Sun. This means that Uranus' poles are located where other planets have their equators, and vice versa. This axial tilt also causes extreme seasonal variations on the planet, with each pole experiencing 42 years of continuous sunlight followed by 42 years of darkness. While Uranus does not have a visible solid surface or any notable geological features, the unique properties of its atmosphere and axial tilt make it a fascinating and unusual planet to study. Exploring Uranus and sending spacecraft to study its surface and atmosphere is a complex and challenging endeavor. Due to its distance from Earth, it takes a significant amount of time and energy to reach Uranus, which makes it difficult to send spacecraft to study the planet in detail. Additionally, the extreme axial tilt of Uranus and its location in the outer solar system make it difficult for spacecraft to orbit the planet and study its surface. Furthermore, unlike rocky planets such as Mars, Uranus does not have a solid surface, so there are no land features to study. Despite these challenges, there have been a few missions that have flown by or studied Uranus from a distance, including the Voyager 2 mission in 1986, which provided valuable information about the planet's atmosphere, rings, and moons. However, due to the difficulty and cost of mounting a mission to Uranus, there are currently no plans for any new missions to the planet in the near future. That being said, there is ongoing research and study of the data gathered by past missions to Uranus, and advancements in technology and space exploration may make future missions to the planet more feasible. Neptune. Neptune, like Uranus, is an ice giant planet without a solid surface. Its atmosphere is made up of mostly hydrogen and helium, with trace amounts of methane, which gives the planet its characteristic blue color. Neptune's atmosphere is characterized by bands of clouds, storms, and a massive anticyclonic storm known as the Great Dark Spot, which is similar in size and shape to Jupiter's Great Red Spot. However, unlike Jupiter's storm, the Great Dark Spot disappeared in the late 1990s and has not been seen since. In addition to the Great Dark Spot, Neptune's atmosphere is also home to several smaller storms, including a series of white clouds known as scooter clouds due to their rapid motion across the planet's surface. Like Uranus, Neptune's unusual tilt also causes extreme seasonal variations on the planet. However, these variations are much more subtle than on Uranus due to Neptune's greater distance from the Sun. While there is no solid land to speak of on Neptune, the planet's atmosphere and unique features make it a fascinating and mysterious object of study in our solar system. NASA's Voyager 2 spacecraft flew by Neptune in 1989 and provided the most detailed images and data we have of the planet to date. Since then, there have been no other missions to Neptune, primarily due to the high cost and technical challenges associated with such missions. Sending a spacecraft to Neptune requires a significant amount of time and resources, as the planet is located over 2.7 billion miles or 4.3 billion kilometers from Earth. It also requires a complex trajectory and advanced propulsion systems to reach the planet. Additionally, exploring Neptune presents unique technical challenges due to the extreme temperatures, radiation, and the planet's strong winds and magnetic field. These factors require specialized equipment and technology to ensure the success of any mission. Pluto. Pluto is the smallest dwarf planet in our solar system and is located in the Kuiper Belt, a region beyond the orbit of Neptune that contains many icy bodies. In 2015, NASA's New Horizons spacecraft performed a flyby of Pluto, providing us with the first close-up images of the dwarf planet. From these images, we learned that Pluto has a solid surface that is primarily composed of ices, including nitrogen, methane, and carbon monoxide. The surface of Pluto is marked by a variety of geological features, including craters, mountains, and plains. Craters are formed by impacts from asteroids or other objects in space, while mountains and plains are created by tectonic activity, such as the movement of the planet's crust. One of the most notable features on Pluto's surface is a large heart-shaped plain called Sputnik Planitia, which is filled with frozen nitrogen, methane, and carbon monoxide. Other features on Pluto's surface include mountains made of water ice, long, winding valleys formed by tectonic activity, and impact craters with bright deposits made of frozen water and other volatile ices. Overall, the surface of Pluto is solid and composed of a variety of frozen ices, with geological features that were formed by impacts and tectonic activity. The observations made by the New Horizons spacecraft have greatly increased our understanding of this distant and enigmatic world.